COPD stands for chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. It's a syndrome that includes emphysema, where the lung is destroyed and replaced by holes. It includes chronic bronchitis, where people have chronic cough and sputum production. And it includes small airway disease, where their small bronchial tubes get narrowed and damaged. So different COPD patients have different combinations of those three things, but they cause airflow obstruction. It makes it hard for them to blow the air out hard and fast, which makes them short of breath and leads to a variety of other health problems. And it's a major cause of death. It's the third leading cause of death in the U.S., major cause of loss of time from work, of disability, and other healthcare costs. COPD gene is a study of more than 10,000 volunteers who are getting careful genetic assessment using state-of-the-art methods, state-of-the-art imaging with CAT scans, and then a variety of other clinical tests like questionnaires and breathing tests so that we can try to understand why some people get COPD and others don't. I think this is really the largest sample of COPD subjects that have ever been well characterized, certainly for a genetic study ever assembled, and that this really has been built as a national and international resource with all the data being deposited into NIH repositories so that people can get access to it. Volunteers were incredibly helpful. I mean, this research would not have been possible without the incredible support from the general population. And 10,000 people to be recruited over a three-year period was a huge effort. Two-thirds of the people were non-Hispanic white, and one-third were African-American. We had a close partnership with the COPD Foundation. It's a patient-run organization that really helped us launch the COPD gene study. It provided support to help us get recruitment for the study, and really every step of the way has been a critical ally for our work. So I think that there's just no way of overemphasizing the importance of volunteerism for this work. If we hadn't had the enthusiastic support from our volunteers who gave their own time to come in, get a CAT scan, go through an extensive array of tests with breathing tests and walk tests and a long list of questionnaires, if they hadn't been willing to do that, we just couldn't do the work. So I think that people need to understand that medical research isn't something that happens out there by other people. If they want new medical discoveries, they should really consider getting involved. They should consider being part of clinical trials, consider being part of these observational epidemiologic and genetic studies, because that's the only way we'll really learn things and we'll advance medical knowledge.